फ्रेंड्स, होयसाला डायनेस्टी और होयसाला एम्पायर इज वन ऑफ द ब्राइटेस्ट स्पॉट इन इंडियन हिस्ट्री। द होयसाला एरा वॉज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट पीरियड इन द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ आर्ट, आर्किटेक्चर एंड रिलीजन इन साउथ इंडिया। एंड टूडे आई टेक यू टू वन ऑफ द ब्यूटिफुल टेम्पल्स ऑफ होयसाला टाइम्स। नमस्कार फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम वंस अगेन टू माई टेम्पल ट्रिप्स। टूडे लेट मी टेक यू टू बेलवाड़ी। ऑन द चिकमंगलूर जवागाल हाईवे, बेलवाड़ी is 29 kilometers southeast of Chikmagalur. The famous town of Bellur and Halebeedu are just a short distance away. Belwadi is a small village, and this place also finds its mention as Ek Chakra Nagara in the great epic of Mahabharata. In fact, villagers organize a festival called as Bandibana every year to commemorate Bhima's victory over Bakasura. It is said that there is a large tank here which has been dedicated to Dhanakaraya, a local chief in whose honor a temple has been built on the bank. This place used to be a center for Jainism as well, and later Krishnaraj Wadiyar II granted this village to Sringeri Math as a donation. The village is famous for a very important temple from Hoysala times called as Veera Narayana Temple, and is also famous for another very important temple of this region known as Udbhava Ganesha Temple or Udbhava Ganpati Temple. And friends, let me first take you to Udbhava Ganpati Temple. So I will talk about this temple first. The Udbhava Ganesha Temple is quite famous in this region and an important tourist destination. In this small hamlet, there is an idol of Lord Ganesha, which is said to have come out by itself, and hence Lord Ganesha here is Swayambhu, and this adds to the importance of this temple. The main deity is Udbhava Ganpati, but then you also have Huttada Ganpati and Varada Ganpati. Huttada means anthill and Varada means boon, which are worshipped here in this Ganpati temple. The Sringeri Samsthana, one of the Adi Shankara's math, is home to the Udbhava Ganpati temple. And as I mentioned before, the idol of Lord Ganpati arose naturally, and hence the idol has been here for decades. And it is also said that this rock on which Lord Ganpati's impression is there is growing day by day. And this adds to the importance of this temple. The Sringeri Samsthan has adopted this village of Belavadi. The temple is maintained by Sringeri Math, and there are a couple of other temples nearby. In front of this temple is a small Sankareshwara temple, which you can visit in case you want to. The building of this temple is fairly new, but the idol of Lord Ganpati has been there for ages. There is ample parking space around the temple. You can spend some good 30 minutes here, and then you can leave for Veeranarayana temple, the Hosala temple which I was talking about. And this Veeranarayana temple is also nearby, so you can walk there or you can take your car to the Veeranarayana temple. Walking will not take more than 5 to 10 minutes. So friends, Udbhava Ganpati temple is a must-see temple around Chikmagaluru and in Belwadi. The temple is open from 9 a.m. to 1:30 p.m. and then it opens from 4 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. The second temple, as I mentioned before, is Veeranarayana temple, and it is the famous Hoysala architecture temple. The temple was built during Hoysala Empire's reign, and as I mentioned before, Belwadi, also known as Ek Chakranagara in legend, is said to be the location where Pandava Prince Bhima killed the demon Bakasura and protected the village and its inhabitants in the epic Mahabharata. King Veerabhalla II of Hoysala Empire got this temple constructed. This is a ornate Trikuta temple, that is, it is a three shrine temple, and it was constructed in 1200 CE. So it is such a old temple and a beautiful, beautiful example of the architecture of that time. Soapstone is the material used, and we know that for all Hoysala temples, the material used is the soapstone. Each of these shrine is one of the largest temples constructed by Hoysala kings. So that is why I'm saying this temple is one of the must visit temples if you are in Chikmagalur or Hassan. This is a Vaishnava temple, and all the three shrines here, all the three, that is ornate Trikuta, all the three shrines here contains the representation of Lord Vishnu and his various avatars. Central shrine, which is the oldest one, this includes an 8-foot tall image of Narayana with four hands, which is one of the best examples of Hoysala art. The idol is in Padmasana. It's well decorated and looks just beautiful. The southern shrine has an 8-foot tall image of Venugopal, that is Lord Krishna playing the flute with a Garuda pedestal, while the north shrine has a 7-foot tall image of Yoga Narsimha in a yoga pose. The shrine towers are ornately adorned with decorative sculptures such as Kirti Mukhas, and you can see this in the video or the photographs. Carving on the wall is very beautiful and is a wonderful, wonderful example of art and culture of that time. Although the famous temples of Belur and Helibidu are well known, this temple is no less than the temples of Belur and Helibidu from my perspective. So friends, if you are traveling to Hassan or Chikmagalur, and if you plan to visit historical temples around that region, I am pretty sure that Belur and Helibidu will be on your mind. But don't forget Belwadi. This is also one of the beautiful temples you can see in that region. This temple remains open from 8 a.m. to 7:30 p.m. The only thing which I would say is that the parking here is a little bit issue, because the temple is right in the middle of the village. The roads are small, parking will be difficult, and if there is a rush, there are more vehicles, parking will definitely can be an issue. So my recommendation is that you can keep your car parked near the Udbhava Ganpati temple and walk down here. So that's all for today, friends. Next time when you visit Hassan or Chikmagalur, do not forget about Belwadi. It is a small village very near to Chikmagalur, Belur and Helibidu, and has these two important and beautiful temples. Hope you like this information. In case you have any questions, do send your comments in the comment box. If you like this information, do like, subscribe and share this video. See you in the next video, friends. Till then, bye-bye.